Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hello, my name is Kimia. It is so good to have you over here in Kimmy's Closet. If you are old, then thank you for coming back. It's so good to see you again. Today's video is it's quite a simple video. It's basically just my style rules, what I follow. They're not like rules, like this is what I have to do every single time. It's basically just kind of like the thought process I have before I buy something and before I make an outfit or while I'm making an outfit. So if you want to stick around and see my 5 styling rules, then just keep on watching this video. Eyebrow raise. I'm also like going blind. Something that I think is important to consider is your lifestyle and really looking at like what you do all the time. I remember when I was in school, the items that caught my eye were pretty much like jeans, sneakers, t-shirts, sweaters, and dresses, because that's what I liked wearing to school most, because that's what I feel most comfortable in. But let's say work in an office most of the time, chances are you're looking at those pieces more. So really looking at your lifestyle and what you do on a consistent basis really affects what you want to buy and what you choose to pick up at the stores, and also how you style your outfits. So just take note of what your lifestyle really is like. If you travel a lot, that's going to affect your purchase patterns. It's going to affect your hair. Like, everything is related to your lifestyle, and I feel like that's pretty obvious. If you don't really dissect your lifestyle, then it's hard to find pieces and incorporate pieces into your wardrobe that you feel like you don't already own, and things that you can dress up or dress down depending on different occasions without dishing out a lot of money. So finding pieces that correlate with your lifestyle and also add a certain flair to your outfits, that's really hard. And I think the big part of it is really just looking at what you do on a consistent basis, how you can use the piece that you're buying different ways. I think the overarching theme is rainbow. The overarching theme is just looking at your lifestyle. Moving on to the first point, for me, it's always quality over quantity. You may have heard this before, you may have not, but I like to buy pieces that I think are worth the money, if you will. I'm not gonna pick up 5 t-shirts that look exactly the same. I'd rather have one that is a certain fabric that I really like. Personally, I don't love 100% cotton when it comes to patterned tops. If I'm buying a floral top, I like it to be linen or just have like a silky looking fabric or something that really just like elevates the top in a way. So for me, it's very much looking at quality versus quantity. And if the quality isn't there, then chances are I'm gonna get sick of it, or I'm gonna wear it only a couple of times, and then when I see it in my closet, I'll just skip past it. So I found that whenever I do go quantity versus quality, those are always the pieces that I rarely ever go towards. I find that the pieces that I've invested in more, I still use year after year. Whereas if I just bought something because it was on sale and like it was buy one, get one free, or it was something like that, and it was an item that I didn't really want in the first place, that's when I end up not really caring about the clothing item and not really using it as much and not feeling good in the item. So looking at quality over quantity is a big thing for me in my style and my wardrobe. My second style rule is about accessories. So personally for me, that is jewelry. I'm a big jewelry person. I think jewelry just really elevates your outfit, or just any kind of accessory. I know people that love sunglasses, I know people that love hats, scarves, really anything that can take your outfit from A to B and add your own kind of style to the look, because anyone can wear a black t-shirt and black pants and sneakers and have that be their outfit, but like the hat you wear will have an impact on the way that you look, and so will your jewelry and just like your belt. It's the little details that I feel like show your personal style, and for me it's always about jewelry. So I'm more of like a classic jewelry wearer. I like just like dainty little necklaces. I'm wearing one right now. I like a lot of rings, like simple dainty rings on multiple fingers, but like literally I would wear a ring on every single finger. I think your accessories are what really show your personality with an outfit. So I love the like classic pieces, but I think if I switch out this little necklace to something that is like more chunky and has turquoise, or like a big choker, my outfit will be completely different, and all I changed was just one accessory. I added one item to it and it looks very different. It gives you a different vibe. So my second styling rule is all about accessories and seeing what small detail I can add to my look that will really showcase my personal style. Is it a ring? Is it a belt? Is it a scarf? Is it something in my hair? Like, what can I really do to show my personal style and elevate my look? If you just throw on some earrings, your outfit will look different and you're like, how did that even happen? All I did was just put on earrings. I haven't even washed my hair. True story. Except today I did wash my hair, I swear. My third rule is all about simplicity. I like my looks to be very simple and look very effortless. So even if I've planned the outfit and I know what I'm gonna wear over or under, I want it to come across as very seamless and very like effortless and simple. So these are all words that basically just go towards simplicity. I want it to look simple, but also show my personal style. So how I do that is I think of the over or under rule. If I'm wearing a certain like dress, I think about what I can wear under it or over it that will make it simple. That's just what I always consider when I put together an outfit or when I buy a certain piece of clothing item. I don't want it to have too much going on, just because if it is like super out there and crazy, then I'm not gonna wear it on a daily basis. Like, I'm not gonna reach for it that often, just because it's not something that I can pair easily with different things. So if I have like striped pants, I'm not gonna pair a floral top with it, because to me that's just too much happening. And I'm sure there are people who can do that, and if you do that, that's amazing. But my personal like rule that I follow is I want it to look simple. I want to be able to pair things together and have them be effortless and look like they look good together without trying too hard. That is just my simple rule. It's just about simplicity and how simple I can make an outfit. Simple, just like The Simple Life. Did you guys ever watch that show? It was really funny. I was very young when I watched it, and I shouldn't have been watching it, but honestly, it was hilarious. So. The fourth rule that I have is about comfort. Now, this one, I am ashamed to say that I always kind of put on the back burner, because shoes, my friends, like, shoes hurt. A lot of my shoes are uncomfortable. The only shoes that I find comfortable are sneakers, but for the most part, my favorite shoes are booties and heels, and they always have the like pointed toe, and this is not a natural shape for your foot to be in, but I just like, I have to put it on the back burner, so I always like put comfort to the side. But it is one of my rules when I buy a clothing item. I'm not gonna buy something that doesn't fit me well, I feel uncomfortable in, just because like, if I feel uncomfortable when I'm trying it on, and I have been there where I've told myself, no, it's fine, like I can totally suck it up, it's super cute, it's a certain price, I love it, I'm gonna buy it, and I've done that, and then I've just regretted it, because every time I put it on, if I'm in a rush or if I'm just like doing anything, I'll put it on and I'll switch into something else that I feel more comfortable in. When I buy something or when I'm putting an outfit together, comfort definitely does go into it, except for the shoe department, because shoes just hurt no matter what. If it's hurting me in the store, I'm not gonna pick it up, but for the most part, comfort is part of my recipe for a cute outfit. My fifth and final styling rule is all about confidence. How do I feel in this outfit? How does this particular top make me feel? How do these pants make me feel? Do I like this? Do I feel great in it? Great, then I'm gonna love it and I'm gonna buy it. If I don't love it, I'm gonna leave it. If I don't love it in the store, I'm not gonna love it when I have it at home and it's sitting in my closet. I might like the straps of a top, but if I don't love the whole top, I'm gonna leave it behind and not buy it, because it's fashion. Like, there's gonna be something within the next week that I'll like. There's gonna be something within the next year that I'll like. Like, you're not gonna lose out on anything if you leave it behind. This has been a sad tale, but like, if you don't buy it now, it's okay. You're gonna find a top that you're gonna love, that's gonna be similar, and you should wait for that top. And I'm talking to myself in the future, because sometimes I see something and I love it and like it looks great on the mannequin and I'll put it on, but like if I don't feel confident in it, if I don't love how I look in it, I'm not gonna buy it. Why should I, right? Like, it's just a waste of money and it's just gonna sit in my closet and I'm not gonna be happy when I see it or when I put it on. So bye-bye, don't need you. If it's like a grandpa sweater and I don't feel amazing in it, I am gonna put it aside. If it's a sexy dress and I don't feel amazing in it, I'm gonna put it aside. And you have to feel good with the outfit that you make. Even with the clothes that you do have, you have to feel good in it, because if you don't, you're gonna be thinking about something else. And like, the whole point of fashion and clothes and styling is to feel amazing and show who you are through that. And you should always feel amazing. So that is basically everything that I have to say. These are just the styling rules that I follow for myself. They're not like rules, they're just kind of like the things in the back of my mind that I keep in mind when I want to buy something or when I put an outfit together, and why I pick the certain pieces that I do to pair with each other. So those are all of my styling rules. I really hope that you enjoyed it. I look like that, like the girl emoji. That's me. And if you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Comment down below anything that you want to see next. And if you're new here, make sure to subscribe and turn on the little bell notification if you want to see more of my videos. But until next time, I hope that you have an amazing day, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye everyone. All the stars are blue.